kidding about that.
सांगाय सपरिवाराय नमः। ओम क्लीं विश्रुवात् पुरा स्त्रीरत्नमेषां कल्याणित्वयास्म गृह्यते दुतुहं प्रस्थस्तेवं तस्यां ज्ञात
Hi everyone, hope you are doing good. We finally moved to a new house. The first few weeks was very chaotic with all the unpacking to be done, and looks like we are almost settled now. Moving to your own home is very exciting. At the same time, it can be very tiring too. I'm going to take you through all of this as much as I can. We sold a lot of our old furniture and bought new ones either from IKEA or Urban Ladder. Our old sofa, the grey gigantic L-shaped sofa, if you remember, was from Urban Ladder. So we thought we would go for a sofa from IKEA this time. I will give you exact detailed living room and dining room tour in my upcoming video. Honestly, I was so irritated to see boxes all around the house, and because of that OCD in me, I wanted anything which came out from the boxes to go at the right place, fully organized, or I was in so much of mental stress. It may sound funny to many, but it's true. Messy house gives me so much of stress than anything else. This is all the extra stock of my pantry, and currently I'm organizing them in the dining area that we made into a breakfast corner kinds, which I will show you in more details in the next video. This drawer has all Kaya's foodstuffs, some snacks, healthy and not so healthy, I know. This one has things like tea leaves, atta, maida, different rice varieties, dal, tetra pak milk for emergencies, etc. This one has some unopened masala packets, noodles, etc. This is one of my best Pinterest found design, and Parth was actually proud of me for this space. After we moved to the new home, we have been so busy that there has been no time for vegetable shopping. My fridge vegetable box had literally gone empty today. But as a mom and a custodian of this family's health, I always need to make sure that daily essentials are available on time for me to cook the day's meal. I have used Fresh to Home app earlier for buying meat and poultry, but recently they introduced me to their Fresh to Home daily app, where I can also subscribe to delivery of daily essentials like milk, eggs, fruits and vegetables, etc. Fresh to Home daily helps me with daily meal essentials delivered before 7:30 a.m. every day. Also, they don't have any minimum order value or subscription charges. I just load the Fresh to Home wallet and ordered the next day's veggies and other essentials the prior evening before the cutoff time to make sure they are ready at my doorstep the next morning. They have 75 plus varieties of milk and other dairy products in their app. Also, there is 5,000 plus range of groceries, fruits and vegetables to choose from. Fresh to Home Daily has now become my go-to app for shopping for produce, dairy products and daily essentials. For dinner tonight, I have some pre-made chicken curry in the fridge. I'm going to only make a quick salad with cucumber, carrots and onions. I'm going to squeeze some lemon juice and mix it with salt and pepper and that's it. By the way, we haven't finalized on a dining table yet, so we are eating on our sofa these days, which is very unlike us. However, since it seemed like a change, Kaya was very happy with it like any other kid.
I'll not get it for eternity.
Kaya, he doesn't know even if you don't whisper to me.
I have recently started using Nandini's Samruddhi milk packet from the app Fresh to Home Daily, which is a full cream milk for making curd. It turns out super delicious, thick and creamy. For the culture, I have used Akshay Kalpa's artisanal organic set curd. You can use anything you prefer. It's really difficult to manage regular vendor milk delivery. In case we are going out for the day, I have to keep a reminder to inform my milk vendor to pause milk for the day. It becomes very convenient when you get milk and other dairy products in the same app. I got milk delivery free for 7 days, which has given me sufficient time to trust the brand for its quality services. As you can see, my kitchen cabinets are almost in order, organized and set. I will show you full tour and details soon and talk about what materials we have used and all in one of my upcoming videos. Fresh to Home Daily have delivered the grocery on time. And this is what I got. Some green tomatoes because they are in season, jackfruit which came cut in a box, apples, oranges, beans, lettuce, Nandini's Samruddhi full cream milk, Akshay Kalpa's curd, some bread and eggs. I also got this small bird eye chilies. These are supposed to be very spicy. I wanted to make some chutney with green tomatoes and this chilies. I will show you that in some time. The curd is also done and I will keep it in the fridge for it to set well. Time to make a quick breakfast. I'm going to make boiled egg sandwich. Kaya loves it, so does Parth, so why not? By the way, this salad spinner from IKEA is such a great thing. I was surprised to see how much water is still left in the leaves even after rinsing off all the water. For making mushroom in butter garlic sauce, in a pan, put some butter along with chopped garlic and 1 teaspoon of maida. Then add the mushrooms along with salt, pepper and chili flakes. And that's it. This is going to taste so good. Try it out and let me know if you liked it. For the stuffing, I'm going to mash eggs and add chopped onions to it along with salt, pepper, chili flakes and mayo. I have also added lettuce as a base and added the egg mixture on top. I also needed to change the sheets because of all the unpacking going on in the house. The sheets seem to get dirty very fast. And the daily chores continue as usual, even in the new house. For lunch today, I'm going to make something special. I'm making some beans fry, dal and jackfruit sabzi with a lot of risk. Parth and Kaya has never eaten jackfruit, both raw and ripe. It used to be one of my favorite sabzi as a child. For the jackfruit sabzi, I'm going to add some oil to a kadai. Then I will add some jeera seeds, chopped onions and fry it for a while. and then add ginger garlic paste along with chopped tomatoes and green chilies. After the onions and tomatoes are well cooked, I will add the jackfruit. And for masala, I will be adding healthy red chili powder, jeera and garam masala. And no one seemed to like the sabzi, and it seems it was the last day I made anything with raw jackfruit. Here's a hack: if you have a drooping aloe vera plant at home, add few sticks on the sides of the pot, and with the help of a rope or thread, I'm going to tie it on every stick so as to support the aloe plant to stand upright. This will help it to grow upright. What I have read, the main reason for a drooping aloe plant is not enough sunlight. Winters in Bangalore is gloomy most days and the sun hardly comes inside the house. Hope this helps it to grow well. I know this video is mostly about unboxing furniture and stuff, but this is what we have been doing for the past few days and weeks. By the way, this is a chair from IKEA. It's called Ikka Neset. I hope I pronounced it right. I loved this chair so much and couldn't help but buy it for our little corner in the balcony. It's a Nordic or Scandinavian style chair and went really well with our decor. Parth calls it the retirement corner because of the slanted back the chair has, I guess. I got few cushion inserts from IKEA. These are called Fialisa and the quality seems pretty good. I also got this laundry bag from IKEA too. It's called Klunka and it has a moisture resistant base at the bottom, which makes it perfect for bathrooms too. I also wanted a clock for the kitchen so that I can fasten my cooking process accordingly. This is our master bedroom and I wanted to keep a blue theme this time. The cushion covers and throw is from IKEA too. I will link them all down. The accent chair is from Urban Ladder. Here's another cozy corner that finally looks put together in our bedroom. We haven't made the ceiling mounted cloth hanger for the balcony yet. Parth was too touchy about the wall and he thought that will make the brick wall look unappealing. Hence we resorted to this foldable cloth dryer for now. The weather seems so bad here that I decided to use the dryer for the bedding, or else it will take forever for the sheets to dry. The living room also looks all done. This wing chair is from IKEA and is called Stredman. It comes with an ottoman too. I love how this corner looks now.
Not on the wing chair! Excuse me! Down!
It's almost dinner time and I'm going to make this spicy green tomato chutney I was talking about in the morning. I will cut them in half and roast them in a pan. I will throw in few cloves of garlic too. I'm also going to make a quick moong dal khichdi. To a pressure cooker I have added some oil, then I will add some jeera seeds, a bay leaf, green chilies and some chopped garlic. To that, I will add the washed rice and moong dal. I have used 1 cup of rice and little less than 1 cup moong dal. I will fry them well. Then I will add salt, haldi and little bit of jeera powder. Then I will add some water and cook it for 2 whistles. For the chutney, I will use my chopper and add the roasted green tomatoes and garlic, chilies, coriander leaves, salt and mustard oil. This combination of khichdi and the chutney is so good. And that's all for today's one. Hope you liked it. And I will be back with a new video really soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.